हारी जय राधा माधव कुंजा बिहारी जगत जन गिरीवर धारी जय गोपी जन गिरीवर धारी जय यशोदानंदन जय ब्रज जनगंजन जय यशोदानंदन जय ब्रज जनगंजन जय लंगी जय कुंज बिहारी जय कुंज बिहारी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम रम रम हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम रम हरे हरे जय राधा माधव की राधे जय पंचतत्पादय लक्ष्मी नरसिंह महादेव भक्त प्रह्लाद जय लक्ष्मी नरसिंह महादेव भक्त प्रह्लाद जय जगन्नाथ जय जगन्नाथ जय बालदेव जय सुभद्रा जय जय प्रभुपाद जय शूल प्रभुपाद जय जय थैंक यू डियर वैष्णव वंचाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः. आई ऑफर माय मोस्ट हम्बल ओबेसेंसेस टू ऑल द असेंबल्ड वैष्णव्स एंड आई हम्बली रिक्वेस्ट फॉर योर ब्लेसिंग्स फॉर योर मर्सी दैट आई मे बी एबल टू स्पीक समथिंग ऑन द श्रीमद् भागवतम दैट विल बी प्लीजिंग टू गुरु एंड कृष्णा एंड टू ऑल ऑफ यू. So this is Srimad Bhagavatam 6.116. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha Shri Chaitanya Mano Bhishtam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam. I was thinking today morning as I was chanting my japa, I was just meditating on Janakinath Prabhu and I was thinking what a stalwart spiritual warrior he is and what an exemplary life he has led in service to Guru Maharaj. And I was thinking when I call him and I leave a little recorded message as I said on our CMS conference, I think I'm going to read out this particular verse because I think it's very inspiring. And then Guru Maharaj called, said, give class. So I said, okay, we will speak on this particular verse in honor of Janakinath Prabhu, because this purport, somehow it just reminds me so much of His Grace Janakinath Prabhu. So I would like to read this verse and speak on it. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय. नारायणं नमस्कृत्यां नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत्। नस्त प्रायश्व भद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती उत्तमा श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी। So I've chosen this verse, which is from the sixth canto, chapter one, which is the story of Ajamil, the very famous story of how Ajamil, a Brahmin boy, fell into a very degraded association. And then when he was almost on the verge of death, how he called out the name Narayan. It's a very, very wonderful pastime and really worth reading over and over again. So this verse goes like this. न तथा हि अगवान् राजन् पुयेता तप आदिभिः यथा कृष्णार्पिता प्राणस् तत्पुरुष निषेवया। Can you take it down a little bit? Thank you. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada ki jai. My dear King, if a sinful person engages in the service of a bona fide devotee of the Lord, and thus learns how to dedicate his life unto the lotus feet of Krishna, he can be completely purified. One cannot be purified merely by undergoing austerity, penance, brahmacharya, and the other methods of atonement I have previously described. Purport. Tat Purush refers to a preacher of Krishna consciousness, such as the spiritual master. Srila Narottam Das Thakur has said, Chadiya Vaishnav Seva Nishtar Payecha Keba. Without serving a bona fide spiritual master, an ideal Vaishnav, who can be delivered from the clutches of Maya? This idea is also expressed in many other places. Srimad Bhagavatam 5.5.2 says, Mahat Sevam Dwaram Ahur Vimukte. If one desires liberation from the clutches of Maya, one must associate with a pure devotee Mahatma. A Mahatma is one who engages 24 hours daily in the loving service of the Lord. As Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita 9.13, Mahatmanastu mam partha daivim prakritim ashritaha bhajanti ananya manaso jnatva bhutadim avyayam. O son of Pritha, those who are not deluded, the great souls, are under the protection of the divine nature. They are fully engaged in devotional service because they know me as the Supreme Personality of Godhead, original and inexhaustible. Thus, the symptom of a Mahatma is that he has no engagement other than service to Krishna. One must render service to a Vaishnav in order to get freed from sinful reactions, revive one's original Krishna consciousness, and be trained in how to love Krishna. This is the result of Mahatma Seva. Of course, if one engages in the service of a pure devotee, the reactions of one's sinful life are vanquished automatically. Devotional service is necessary not to drive away an insignificant stock of sins, but to awaken our dormant love for Krishna. As fog is vanquished at the first glimpse of sunlight, one's sinful reactions are automatically vanquished as soon as one begins serving a pure devotee. No separate endeavor is required. The word Krishna Arpita Prana refers to a devotee who dedicates his life to serving Krishna, not to being saved from the path to hellish life. A devotee is Narayana Parayana or Vasudeva Parayana, which means that the path of Vasudev or the devotional path is his life and soul. Narayana Para Sarve Na Kutaschana Bibhyati, Bhagavatam 6.17.28. Such a devotee is not afraid of going anywhere. There is a path toward liberation in the higher planetary systems and a path towards the hellish planets. But a Narayana Para devotee is unafraid wherever he is sent. He simply wants to remember Krishna wherever he may be. Such a devotee is unconcerned with hell and heaven. He is simply attached to rendering service to Krishna. When a devotee is put into a hellish condition, he accepts them as into hellish conditions, he accepts them as Krishna's mercy. Tattenukampam su samikshamana. Bhagavatam 10:14:8. He does not protest. Oh, I'm such a great devotee of Krishna. Why have I been put into this misery? Instead, he thinks, this is Krishna's mercy. Such an attitude is possible for a devotee who engages in the service of Krishna's representative. This is the secret of success. Umagyanati mirantasya jnananjana shalakaya chakshur unmilitam yena tasmai shri guruve namaha. So this particular verse and purport is completely giving us the path to pure bhakti. And what is that? To serve the pure spiritual master, to be fully engaged in his service. And such a person who is a preacher of Krishna consciousness is a great soul, according to Bhagavad Gita, Mahatma. What is the meaning of Mahatma? One who is fully engaged in the service of the Lord 24 hours a day. He has no other engagement, and he is simply engaged in loving Krishna, serving Krishna, worshipping Krishna, directing others how to serve Krishna, how to worship Krishna. Such a person is called a Mahatma. And one who sincerely engages in the service of the great Mahatmas, that means the great spiritual masters, he can make his life successful. So Narottam Das Thakur has said, without serving a spiritual master who is an ideal Vaishnava, who can be delivered from the clutches of Maya? Nobody can be expect to be disentangled from the clutches of Maya without serving a pure devotee, because only one who is free can free you. People don't understand this basic concept. You know, they run here and there looking for temporary solutions. They think, oh, Barack Obama will save me. Oh, this Sadhguru will save me, or that person will save me, this person will save me, this person will give me the path to complete happiness and joy. But we must understand that unless we take shelter, complete shelter, and follow the path of bhakti in the footsteps of the great devotees, this is one of the principles, six principles of favorable devotional service, following in the path of the great souls, we will not become free. We will only get more and more entangled, because those who promise temporary material happiness in the name of, I will get you a good job, I will make sure you get a good home, I will make sure you get a good wife or husband, I will arrange this for you, that for you, which is all on the material platform, is himself deluded, and he will take his followers also into that delusion. One who is bound cannot free another. But one who is free can free another. So who is free? The person who is free is the one who is situated completely in the spiritual energy, completely in transcendence, above the material modes. And how is that possible? Only by becoming pure and being completely engaged 24/7 in the worship of the Lord. So this idea, as this purport is explaining, is expressed in many other places, especially Srimad Bhagavatam. We spoke about this last time. Mahat Seva, you know, by service to the great souls, we can get freed from the clutches of Maya. We can become disentangled. And once we become free, what does that mean? We are no longer affected by the material energy. We are no longer subjugated by the material energy. And we become more and more absorbed in the devotional service of the Lord. So this contamination of the material energy needs an expert physician, needs an expert doctor. And what is that medicine? Enechi aushadhi maya nasi baro lagi hari nama maha mantra lao tumi magi. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. So this Hare Krishna maha mantra is the Yuga Dharma for this age of Kali. And we must begin chanting the holy names in real earnest, following the orders of the spiritual master. So along with the medicine, we get a diet. What is that diet? Krishna Prasadam. We only take food that is offered to the Lord and nothing else. And what is the engagement? Krishna's seva as directed by the spiritual master. Once we do this, once we take complete shelter like this of the pure devotee of the Lord, completely engage in the process of devotional service. And what is this engagement? It means following the orders of the spiritual master. What is the order? Srila Prabhupada says, everyone must rise early in the morning by 4 o'clock, take part in Mangala Arati, chant the holy prayers to the spiritual master, worship the Lord, perform Tulsi Puja, chant all the prayers following that, and engage in very concentrated, earnest japa, really calling out to Krishna to please engage us in his devotional service, to please give us full protection from the material energy, to please purify our intelligence, purify our hearts, get rid of all the material anarthas that are contaminating our, so our hearts and our bhakti lata beach surrounding, you know, we have so many weeds, so many anarthas, which are blocking the luxuriant growth of our bhakti lata beach. So we want to very carefully do the weeding process, even while we are doing the watering process. The watering process is hearing and chanting the glories of the Lord. Along with that, we must carefully weed all the anarthas from our heart, so our bhakti lata beach can grow very nicely, and we must engage in the service of the Lord as given by the spiritual master. Why the spiritual master? Because these are the great souls. They are not deluded. They are not swayed by the material energy. They are unaffected by the material energy because they are under complete protection of the spiritual energy, under the divine nature. And they are fully engaged in the service of the Lord, knowing only Krishna. So this pure devotee of the Lord, our bona fide spiritual master, is the one who can guide and lead us to make our life perfect. So we must render service to the spiritual master in order to get freed from sinful reactions and reawaken our original Krishna consciousness. What is our original Krishna consciousness? Our original Krishna consciousness means what? Pure love for Krishna. This is actually our nature. We are eternal spirit souls, part and parcel of Krishna, and we are simply meant to render loving service to Krishna. Jivera Swarup Hoy Nityera Krishna Das. And how we can come back to this position? By rendering service to the Mahatma, Mahatma Seva. And of course, as a result of engaging in this process of devotional service, we get rid of a lot of sinful reactions. But that is not really the purpose. The purpose is to come back to our perfection, which is what? Pure loving servant of Krishna, to be engaged fully in the path of devotional service and to be completely absorbed in devotional service, not having any distraction, not having any other motive other than to please the spiritual master, to please Srila Prabhupada, and to please Krishna. Because when we please Krishna, we are actually coming back into our original position. We are not meant to please our own selves. We think that. We think we are, you know, when we come to this material world, we immediately come in contact with material nature. There's no escaping that. We come in contact, we get a material body. That's the first thing. Once you get a material body, you forget Krishna consciousness. Actually, it is described that, you know, souls, when they are in the womb, they are in such a suffering condition, and they're calling out to the Lord and saying, my dear Lord, I'm suffering so much. I promise when I come out, I will engage in your devotional service. But the moment we come out, we forget everything. And we start trying to enjoy the material nature. But this enjoyment actually is a cause of our entanglement. It implicates us in more and more reactions and counter reactions and further reactions, some pious, some impious. And so there's suffering, there's enjoyment, there's suffering, there's enjoyment, there's suffering, there's enjoyment. And this goes on and on and on. And what is the end result? Another material body. Back again to the material world. Again take birth. Again go through all those things. So we have done this millions of times, brothers and sisters. We don't need to do this again and again. Let us become intelligent and take to the path of Krishna consciousness. Serve our spiritual master, our dear beloved spiritual master, who is a pure devotee of the Lord, firmly fixed in pure bhakti, who is there to guide us and lead us back to Krishna. One such great soul who is really following our Guru Maharaj is Janakinath Prabhu. I have personally seen how he engages in service to Guru Maharaj, completely devoted to making Guru Maharaj happy in all respects and completely situated in absolutely more of goodness, that's for sure. Because he does not get angry, he does not get irritated, he does not lose his temper, he is very even keeled in all situations, he is extremely patient and tolerant, he is very sweet, he has got a very kind-hearted, patient, tolerant, compassionate nature that simply wants to serve Guru Maharaj. He has a firm grasp on Shastra, his knowledge is phenomenal, he has understood it so well that it has become vigyan. It is not theoretical anymore. He has acquired realized knowledge. That means what? He has absorbed it, he has imbibed it, he has practiced it, and now he's getting realization. And from that position of realization, he gives classes which are such interesting, unique, and captivating that people are just mesmerized by how nicely he presents the class. I have personally experienced Janakinath Prabhu's classes and they are phenomenal. He is an exemplary, stalwart spiritual warrior who is showing us how to follow Guru Maharaj. I remember when Janakinath Prabhu had come with our Guru Maharaj to my home and some description of something was going on and some kirtan was going on and he said, oh, that's Achyuta Gopi. I had not really known so much about kirtaniers. And Achyuta Gopi's voice is, you know, very manly kind of a voice. So I said, no, that's not Achyuta Gopi. Thinking, I know. Janakinath Prabhu said nothing. It was Achyuta Gopi. But he never said, no, it is Achyuta Gopi. I know, I've heard it. I've heard her before. I know better than... He said nothing. He just continued with his service calmly, sweetly, kindly. And it took me time to understand this is really Achyuta Gopi. See, this is the character of a true Vaishnava. How compassionate, how kind he is, and how patient he is with my childish behavior. You know, I'm like a little kid around him. I have so much to learn from Janakinath Prabhu. He is an exemplary disciple of our Guru Maharaj. And he embodies so many virtues that only if you are in his association, you can begin to experience all those different qualities. I cannot even describe them, but I know for sure that he is completely sold out to Guru Maharaj. He is completely devoted to Guru Maharaj and he's completely engaged in the service of the Lord with Guru Maharaj's instructions. So therefore, he's always blissful. If you look at this purport further down, could you take us a little further down the purport, Lavanya, please? I want to come to that part where it says devotee is, yeah. Just look at this very last paragraph and you can almost see Janakinath's face over there. He, Krishna Arpita Prana, he has just surrendered his life. He has dedicated his life to Krishna. And he doesn't care what happens to his body, what happens to his finances, what happens to his health, what happens to his relatives, what happens to this. He is completely sold out to the mission of the spiritual master. And devotional life is his heart and soul, his life and soul. And so whatever condition of life he is put in, he is simply unafraid. He's simply fixed in his devotional service. And he's simply attached to rendering service to Krishna. And how does he accept his situation? Tattenu kampam su samikshamano bunjana evatma kritam vipakam ridvag vapurbir vidadati kaman. I forget. What, can you pull that up for us? Ridvag vapurbir vidadati kaman. Jiveta yo mukti padesa dayabhak. That is 10, 14, 8. It's a really wonderful, wonderful verse.
Mataji, you want to go to that verse?
Yes, please.
Okay.
Wait a minute. Maybe just for 1 second. Okay, never mind. Yeah. Tatenukam
susamikshamano.
Yeah. Tatenukampam susamikshamano. Bunjana evatma kritam vipakam. Ridva vaburbir vidadan namaste. Jiveta yo mukti pade sadaya bhak. Look at this beautiful translation. My dear Lord, one who earnestly waits for you to bestow your causeless mercy upon him, all the while patiently suffering the reactions of his past misdeeds and offering you respectful obeisances with his heart, words, and body, is surely eligible for liberation, for it has become his rightful claim. And in this very beautiful purport, there's such a wonderful description that a legitimate son has to simply remain alive to gain an inheritance from his father. Simply by remaining alive in Krishna consciousness, therefore, we become eligible to receive the mercy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. In other words, he will be promoted to the kingdom of God. Hari Bol! So, Janakinath is actually showing us the way. He's actually, by his example, he's teaching us. He is completely, completely fixed in his service to Guru Maharaj. He's completely on the transcendental platform now. And he is, wherever his soul is, it is engaging in Krishna service. So, we must understand that whatever sufferings, difficulties, trials, tribulations, challenges, obstacles, they're actually meant to make us more purified. They're actually meant to make us move to a higher level in our Krishna consciousness. Of course, it's not easy. Nothing worthwhile is ever easy. It's always going to be challenging. But if we go through the test, we will come out stronger, more purified, more fixed in the service of the Lord, and less attached to the material energy than we were before. We will actually see this in our own life as we practice Krishna consciousness. We will actually see these wonderful things happen, provided we keep faith and carefully, steadily, unwaveringly follow the process of Krishna bhakti. That means we don't give up. We don't say, oh, this difficulty has come. Oh my God. Today, how can I keep my vow of chanting 16 rounds? I have this, I have that, I have that. And then we say, oh, never mind. Maybe I will chant tomorrow. Today is too difficult. But actually, that's a test. Are you going to keep your vow? Are you going to chant your rounds no matter what? This is the vow you took. And so we must understand our vows come first. Our service comes first. And then when we do that first, it provides a strong foundation on which the rest of the day can be built. But if you put all those other things first, it's topsy-turvy. If we run after the material, we will actually lose both material and spiritual. But if we run after the spiritual, we'll always gain the spiritual. We may or may not gain materially, but we will never lose spiritually. This is the beauty of Krishna consciousness. There is no loss or gain in this process. There is no loss and only gain in engaging in the service of the Lord. Let's go back to that purport, please, Lavanya. Thank you. Yes. See here, he does not protest. Oh, I'm such a great devotee of Krishna. Why have I been put into this misery? Instead, he thinks, this is Krishna's mercy. A true devotee actually says, my dear Lord, I should have suffered far, far more than this. You have actually made it very small for me. You have minimized it so that I'm not completely overwhelmed and finished. You're giving me a chance to come up in my bhakti, to engage myself deeper in this process of devotional service, to purify myself of all unnecessary things that I have saddled myself with life after life. And such an attitude is possible for one who engages in the service of Krishna's pure representative, the spiritual master. So it's only by the spiritual master's mercy. Yasya prasadar bhagavat prasado, yasya prasadar nagati kutopi, Dhyayanstuvamstasya Yashastri Sandam Vande Guru Shri Charanaravindam. This is the prayer to the spiritual master that we sing every morning in Guru Puja. What is that? Only by the mercy of the spiritual master can one become successful. And without his mercy, no possibility of success. To such a pure devotee of the Lord, we offer our obeisances 3 times a day. So our the pure spiritual representative of Krishna has come in the form of the spiritual master to deliver us from the nations of being in this material world, to take us out of the darkness and once and for all make our life perfect and go back to Krishna, eternally living in the kingdom of God. What greater benefactor can then be in this world? Who can be a greater benefactor than the pure spiritual master who comes down from the spiritual world just to pick us up and take us back to Krishna? Can you imagine a greater well-wisher than the spiritual master? There is none. In fact, for the living entity, the only person who can help is the spiritual master. In truth, there is nobody who can help us except the spiritual master, because only he can free us from the clutches of Maya, from the darkness of ignorance, from the illusions and trappings of this material energy, and can free us and put us on the path to bhakti and gradually help us rise to higher and higher and higher levels of bhakti. We have a long way to go. We have a long way to go. Krishna prema is the goal. And some of us are at sadhu sangha, bhajana kriya, anartha nivritti, nishtha. And then we have to make progress more and more and more. We have to become fixed, nishtha, then asakti, then ruchi, then bhava, and then Krishna prem. So the ladder is very long and high and big, but we must slowly keep making progress. Because if we are not making progress, it means we are going to be stagnated or pushed back. Material energy is so strong that if we are not making a concerted effort to push against her, she will push us back. So there is no question of, I will just remain where I am. It's not possible. If we are not strenuously trying every day to improve ourselves and to make our sadhana a little better than yesterday, to make our devotional service a little better than yesterday, what happens is Maya has a way of pushing us back. So our efforts should be ongoing, they should be continuous, they should be steady, and they should be without wavering, without giving up, with having full faith that this process will take me to the goal of Krishna consciousness, will take me back to Krishna. So we have a very wonderful process. We have a wonderful spiritual master. We have wonderful Srila Prabhupada. We have Lord Chaitanya, who is most wonderful, the most magnanimous, munificent, most merciful, most compassionate, most charitable, most liberal, kindest avatar who can ever imagine. The merciful avatar, more merciful than Lord Chaitanya, not possible. And so Lord Chaitanya, understanding how fallen we are in this age of Kali, has come to give us a very simple, sweet, sublime process. Chant Hare Krishna, take Krishna Prasadam, engage in the service of the Lord under the guidance of the pure devotee, make your life successful. Very sweet, very simple, very sublime process of making our life perfect. So I would like to end over here. Thank you very much for listening very, very patiently to this little discourse. We can now open up for questions, comments, realizations, discussion. Thank you so much. Hare Krishna.
Thank you so much, Mataji. Very nice class. Thank you so much. I didn't have any association with His Grace Janakinath Prabhuji, but last year in the retreat, I heard his class. So it was very inspiring, and he gave a lot of tips how to please Guru Maharaj. So That was my my small association with me with him. So, but I pray for him, Mataji.
Yes, he is a very wonderful stalwart preacher. If it's Krishna's desire, we can really pray for him to be with us for a long, long time to come, because he has so much to offer. He has already offered so much, and he has so much more to offer. He's just a very phenomenal person. If you see Janakinath Prabhu, you will just be amazed how many good qualities Krishna has put in one person. You know, in London, it is hard to catch the attention of anyone. Everybody's in such a rush, you know, subways, this, that. Prabhu came up with magic tricks. You know, he had a pack of cards and he said, hey, let me show you some magic tricks. And he captured the attention of people and somehow managed to give books, give mantra cards, give, you know, in those few minutes that people's attention span is so little, they have no time, they're not interested. He would somehow manage to connect with people and give them Krishna. He used his, you know, cancer treatment as a way to go on to do cancer retreats for some of the cancer survivors. And they got a chance to come to the manor. They got to see Krishna. They got to experience prasadam. They got the whole philosophy. It was like, wow, imagine these people who would never otherwise see Krishna, hear about Krishna, take Krishna prasadam. They actually came to the manor. They were in various stages of cancer themselves. Who knows how long they would be in that material body, but because of Janakinath's mercy, they got Krishna prasadam. They got to see Krishna. They got to hear the kirtan. They got to hear the philosophy. And this is really the success of life, is what? To give Krishna to others. So I'm very much inspired to share this about Janakinath Prabhu.
Thank you, Mataji.
Thank you.
Devotees, if you have any questions or comments or realizations, please go ahead.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Namrata. Please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. All glories to our Gurudev.
Oh, please accept my humble obeisances. Humble Vaishnava Pranam, Mataji. Vanchakalpadarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhya Evacha Patitanam Pavanebhya Vaishnavibhyo Namo. Yes, the Janakinath Prabhuji's the qualities you are talking about, I haven't come across him, but yes, I have heard about him from my cousin. I haven't heard never have I heard about his lectures also. No personal association as well, as I'm in India. I just recently, last 8-9 months, I was a little geared up in my devotional service. But yes, I really, this is an amazing thing when you watch such a person who can convert the crisis into an opportunity. So the cancer which he is going through, of course, it is, we will always pray, we'll do some extra chanting for him. Definitely, as devotees, we will definitely wish a well wish for him. But even if we are not there, then he has such a great capabilities of converting his situation into, you know, and elevating the higher purpose. So I find this really mercy. Somehow it is a mercy of Krishna also, a mercy of Prabhupada also, that in such a situation, he would be, I think, more geared up to, you know, if he must be giving 20%, 30%, he'll be giving more, 80%, 90%, because he has such a situation. So that is how a devotee's attitude, a perfect devotee attitude is. So very inspiring. Yes, very inspiring.
Thank you, Namrata. Thank you for sharing your realizations and your loving thoughts for Janakinath. Thank you very much. He is very dear to all of us.
Yes, I would definitely look forward to listen more to him, his lectures and all. Yes, I look forward to that.
Yeah, we are all praying for him to come out of this latest crisis, but we don't know what is Krishna's plan. Let us pray that if it's Krishna's desire, that he comes back and can preach for another 36 years more. Why not 40 years more? He's only 36 years old.
Yes, we definitely need such devotees.
Yes.
We have a crisis of devotees also. I mean, we desperately need some, you know, senior and good devotees.
Right. We need to get inspired from devotees who are fixed. And he is definitely fixed in his service to Guru Maharaj. He's very fixed in his dedication, his life, giving his life. So we can learn so much from just being in the association of this great soul.
Yes, yes, very true. Yes. Thank you, Mataji. This is what I wanted to share. Yeah.
Thank you, Namrata. I appreciate very much your sharing and your deep concern for Janakinath.
Hare Krishna. Please give, please pass on my best wishes and humble obeisances.
Okay, we will try that. Maybe we can pass on that through Bhakta Roberto. We can try for that.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you.
I guess nobody has any comments, Mataji.
Okay. So then we will...
Hare Krishna?
Yes.
I'm sorry. If nobody's there, can I ask one more question?
Yeah.
Yes, of course. Of course. We have time. We have 15 minutes more.
Okay. So I'm really on the neophyte level, so please treat me that way. But I've been going to temple services recently, and one thing I really face. Okay, this is India, and the you know, people here have their own mindsets, and you know, they come to temple in their way. But I really feel. When I'm going to temple and doing some seva, I see people. I mean, if I'm going, then it is all Matajis around me. We have the seva with Matajis. So I find Mataji is doing a lot of prajalapas and gossip. So, you know, sometimes how do we keep ourselves away during the service? Away from this prajalapas or, you know, gossips, and while we are doing the service.
Yeah, I remember, you know, as a newcomer, you know, joining a community, and I was just overwhelmed by all the, you know, gossip around and all the unnecessary talks, all the prajalapa, as you said. And I remember writing to Guru Maharaj, and our Guru Maharaj wrote back to me, and he said, very strictly avoid gramya katha. That means avoid all this village gossip. So when you're over there, what you can do is, you know, plug in your ears, you know, carry a little lecture of Prabhupada or Guru Maharaj, and have your earphones in place so that you're constantly hearing only transcendental sound vibration. Either you're listening to Prabhupada, or you're listening to Guru Maharaj, or you're listening to a kirtan, or you're listening to Prabhupada japa tape, something, so that you're not hearing all the other things while your hands are working with the others. You don't have to hear what they're saying. Do you understand?
Yes, I get it. Yes.
I've seen many devotees. They walk around the temple. They go around doing all their duties. But they're deaf to what is happening around them. Why? Because they have plugged their ears and they are only listening to a lecture or kirtan or something to connect them to the transcendental sound vibration. We have to protect our consciousness. That is the most important job of a devotee, to protect his or her consciousness from the attacks of Maya. Let's not kid ourselves. The moment we are up, we are in the battlefield. This is like a Kurukshetra war every day. We have to protect our bodies, our minds, our senses, our consciousness from all the things that will come at us. And how will we do that? By keeping our sadhana strong. Is like putting on your armor for the day. It's like putting on your spiritual armor and saying, yes, today I will go out and I will face Maya and I will come out victorious. I will not let her get me down. And so for that, we have to think that anywhere, anyhow, the attack will come. So I must be on my guard. A spiritual warrior is always careful to see that there is no chink in his armor for Maya to penetrate. Of course, we are still in the neophyte stage. So we are constantly fumbling, falling, and we have to pick ourselves up and we have to say, oh Krishna, I made a mess. I have to learn from this too. So we are not perfect, but we can take shelter by this process of taking all precautions not to get affected by what is happening around us or what other people are just throwing at us. Whether it's prajalpa, whether it's, negative talk or anything. We have to really, we have to guard our eyes, what we see on the internet. You know, for me, it's always a challenge. I'm navigating these tabs. I want to go to Vedabase. By the time I'm clicking on Vedabase, there's all these news items, Haiti president shot dead, this thing happened, that thing happened. It's so easy to get distracted and to think, oh, I have to see what's happened in the news. We have to protect our eyes. We have to protect our ears. We have to protect our bodies. We have to protect our tongue. From all this, our sense organs are constantly looking to grab onto sense objects. But what is that going to do? It is only going to implicate us more in the material energy. So we have to protect ourselves. Not just hearing, seeing, thinking, all these things have to be protected. I don't know if that's helpful to you.
Yes, it is helpful. I think I can do that. I was just thinking that, I'm going to temple to take association of devotees. I didn't want, make them feel bad. Okay, I'm alone, plugging in the earphones and doing seva without communicating to others. So what I was doing is, in all those Matajis, I found the, I noticed one Mataji, she was least doing the prajalapa. So I just sat beside her and, I was doing my seva. That is what I did last time. But yes, I think I can do what you are also suggesting. So I can do that.
Well, I don't want you to feel that you're hurting other people. You might have to be intelligent and think a little bit how you can do this in such a way that you're not upsetting other people or hurting their sentiments. I'm talking about the West. When I describe what I have seen in the temples, I've seen so many people wearing that self, earphones and doing their seva. But I'm talking about the Western world. So I don't know if that advice will be applicable to your particular situation. You might have to see very carefully which Mataji is someone whom you can take shelter of. You might want to look around and see which Mataji is really, not indulging in prajalpa, and try to do seva with her.
Yes, Mataji. Yes. Yes, that is what I found last time. I mean, there's an old lady whom I found. She was least indulging. Of course, she was asking certain things, but related to her service. So I found her, you know, better I sit beside her. And I tried a little talking to her, and yes, because when you're going to not just temple, but you know, you when you are meeting a devotee, you're more excited to talk about Krishna, you're more excited to talk about what they are experiencing in their devotional services and all that, share the experiences, you know. And so if you find a person like that, you want to engage with that rather than, you know, the prajalapas.
Yeah, prajalapa lounge, you know, this is to be strictly avoided. Actually, this is an injunction, you know, strictly avoid the prajalapa lounge. This is, you know, if you go anywhere, you will hear repeatedly the same thing, that don't get into those places, those corners where all is going on, because that's not good for our spiritual life anyway. It affects our consciousness negatively, you know. So really try to see, be very discriminatory in seeking out good association. This is very important point. You want to be very careful whom you're associating with, because you want to get uplifted through the process of association. You want to go to a higher level in your own sadhana, in your own practice, in your own Krishna consciousness. So you really have to be careful with whom you're associating, Namrata.
Yes, Mataji. Yes, very true. And it doesn't matter if we have a quantity of devotees, rather we concentrate on the quality of devotees we are associating.
Exactly, exactly. We don't want, you know, to win popularity contest or anything. We don't want to hurt people also unnecessarily, but we definitely want to protect our Bhakti Lata beach. That is actually our single most important responsibility. Which temple you're associated with, if I may ask?
I'm in Surat in Gujarat in India. So we have two ISKCON temples here. The one is the old one. Old one is like very old, and another temple is open, which is like 4 or 5 years old here, which is a little near to my place.
Okay. So okay. You know, and one thing I can suggest for you, Namrata, is to really start praying to Krishna to send you association that is good for your spiritual life.
Yes, Mataji, very true. Yeah, I'll do that.
Because we need that. We really need that. It's very difficult otherwise to continue in Krishna consciousness. We need inspiring association.
And if I talk about myself, I am also very choosy about, you know, people who are, you know, associating with me, or who can, you know, be like friendly with me. So I'm very choosy on that. I cannot, and some people are, they mix very easily, but I cannot do that so easily. Anyways, I'm in the slower process and I have to, you know, filter them.
So yeah, they say that one should make a friendship with like-minded people. People who are like-minded, that means we have the same wavelength, we have the same mood, we have the same desires to serve. You know, they should be gentle, they should be kind, and they should be pleasant to be with. And then we can associate with them. So I think it is wise to be a little discriminatory and choose your association wisely, rather than rushing, you know, into something and then regretting or having a fallout, because that's not good, you know, for your spiritual life.
Yes, Mataji, very true.
Hope that was helpful. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yes, thank you, Mataji. Thank you very much for the advice.
Hare Krishna, thank you for giving me an opportunity to serve you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Okay, if anybody has anything further to say, please go ahead and say it now, about Janakinath or about this verse or about your own realizations. Or if not, we can end the call. Okay, I think that's it, Lavanya.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
Thank you very much for hosting us and putting up the verse.
Thank you.
And shifting quickly from one to the other, one to the other. Thank you for doing that. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Mataji.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Srinivas Prabhu. My humble obeisances to all the assembled Vaishnavas. Vanchakalpataru Krishna. Hare Krishna. Guru Maharaj ki jai. Prabhupada ki jai.